Hello everyone, welcome to Civil Nirman. In this session, we are going to discuss changes in wind speed that has been made by BIS in the recent release of amendment number 2. Changes of basic wind speed for various cities has been updated according to the NBC 2016 version. Also, some other changes has been updated. So, let me take you to that particular amendment. So here I have downloaded this amendment from the BIS website. You can observe whatever the changes has been updated, they are mentioned here with respect to a particular clause and page number. So if you want this document, you just have to register yourself on BIS website with your mobile number and mail ID, and simply you can get the access to this amendment. So let me take you to the website. It will look something like this. Once you registered and search for the amendment, it will highlight something like this. So you can observe over here, two amendments are there for IS 8753. This is your code for wind load, right? Amendment number 1 was released in 2016 and the amendment number 2 is in June 2020. So you can get this document from here. Now let's switch to the changes. So for your understanding, I am taking one example. Let's say here on page 7, table 1 is given with a change that all general buildings and structures and ground based freestanding tower up to 50 meter, this category is updated. So let's look into the code. So here in table number 1, that is for your risk coefficient K1, the first category class of structure is updated. So previously it is all general buildings and structure. Now instead of this, updated class of structure will be all general buildings and structures and ground based freestanding tower up to 50 meter. So the ground based freestanding tower category is updated over here. Similarly, you can check out all other changes as well. Let's look into another example. See, let's say here from page number 5, in certain clauses the figure number 1 of part 6 is replaced by with the National Building Code of India 2016, that is from the NBC. Means if you observe in our code, that is IS 875 part 3 2015, we have figure number 1, right, for basic wind speed in meter per second. So after amendment number 2, if you wish to refer basic wind speed map of India, now instead of this you have to refer basic wind speed map from NBC 2016, that is our national building code. So let me show you NBC 2016 wind map as well. So you can observe the updated wind speed map from NBC 2016. So this wind map is updated with the latest wind speed, right? So here in every particular clause, the figure 1 will be replaced by the wind map from NBC 2016, right? Similarly, you can read all other changes as well. So you can get the clear idea about all the changes from this document. Now let's switch to the wind speed changes. So here, for your understanding, what I have done, I have consider the table from our code and highlighted the wind speed with a color code. You can check out the difference with the color code, right? So here are the list. Here are the list of cities whose wind speed has been changed, and other cities are with the same wind speed which was earlier in the previous version, right? Now let's say with a blue color code, I have highlighted all the cities whose wind speed has been increased. So you can easily identify that particular. Or what you can do, you can refer the amendment number 2 here, in that updated wind speed is given, and you can compare this wind speed with the actual wind speed given in your IS-875 part 3, so you can easily identify the changes. Alright, now see, here I have marked all the cities with the increase or decrease in wind speed, so you can easily understand this. So let's say Chandigarh, in Chandigarh the earlier wind speed was 47, now after amendment 2 the wind speed is increased as 50. If I take the example of Vadodara, the wind speed will be 39, earlier it was 44, right? So while calculating the wind speed for a particular structure, if you are working on certain projects, make sure you consider the latest wind speed, and based on that you consider the wind load. I hope this video will help you all. If you like the video, share with other engineers. Keep learning, keep sharing.